Okay, hello and welcome. Next I like to show you that how this car's outer drive belt works and how this tensioner also works. There is now situation that in that engine there is all parts in right position and everything is fine and tensioning is also fine, and this part in here is this drive belt, and what purpose is to move and give power in this alternator what is in here, and also in this power steering pump what moves our wheels, and in here we have water pump, and that part is tensioner what makes this belt to become fast, like in that way that it is fastened, and then there is often in that area also this air condition pump place in here, it's place in here. Okay, and how then this system works? It works so that first we need to start this car engine. And here is, by the way, this car engine's crankshaft. There is oil sump in here. And in that area, there is this cylinder head. And in these areas in here, pistons are moving in that way. And normally in that area, there is exhaust manifold and exhaust pipe. And in that area is intake manifold and fuel injection system. This was like this information. Okay, and then first step. When we start this engine start to run. And normally this engine runs in clockwise, and this means that in that direction, not in this way. Normally they runs in that way, always in same way. And then when it moves that big wheel in here, there is this belt what is very strength and durable, and there is also those small holes in here inside, and it takes good contact in that metallic wheel. And then when we look in that area, we can see that there are those holes in this metallic crankshaft pulley wheel. Okay, and then when this engine start runs, I demonstrate that I have here my friends, and then 19 millimeter socket, and this bolt is the best way to run this engine because this is extremely tight and fastened bolt. And I insert that my tool in here, and then I start rotate, and then happens so that when this belt moves, then all of these parts moves in same way. And it's good to rotate this crankshaft wheel in only one position, because if we rotate that in different way in wrong rotation, then there can happen something. Okay, but then when this wheel moves, that part, this is not necessary because this is only it support and keep this belt fasten and tighten. Actually it is of course important because it purpose is to fasten and tighten this belt. Okay, and then that part in here, this is important because this wheel creates in that power steering pump this power, and it means that when this rotates, then this system generates this oil force to our steering wheels, and then our wheels moves better. And then when this belt moves again, there is this our alternator, and that part what generates electricity to our car, and this electricity is must on.
Okay, and then when we looked at my this drive belt work, when I rotate this my crankshaft using my wrench, this is this rotation direction, look in that way, it is like clockwise. And here is water pump, and this is really important part. And if drive belt files or cut, then our water pump, it don't work, and it is really emergency situation, because car engine overheats and it becomes really hot and engine becomes broken. And remember that if you notice that this alternator warning light is on, then also water pump can be off. And that's this crankshaft moves all parts. And then we can look this drive belt inner area, because it must be look so nice what we saw, because this drive belt must move all of these parts. This, and this is power steering feel, that left part in here what I am touching, and this pump gives power to our steering wheels. And then there is this alternator what I am now touching, and this alternator must be fasten this belt, and soon I show that how this tensioner works, because it is also very important thing in here. Okay, and there is water pump in here. And now we are in this tensioner feel, what is this central black feel. And water pump moves in same direction, and actually it moves same with this belt. Interesting. Okay. And there must be good contact with this belt and like this water pump area. Okay, and then we can look this belt inside area, and there is this tensioner. This is the correcting what compressed this belt in well. And there is then this hydraulic piston what I am touching, and this makes this force, that this central bolt what I am touching, when this force goes down, then this feel goes up and it fasten this belt. And there is compression oil and air inside this piston what I am touching. This is tensioner, this spring. And now when this piston goes down, then this feel pops up. And there is two bolts in this tensioner what we have to move, and then this tensioner moves. Look in this what I am soon touching. And this is nice system, this Toyota's tensioner system, very very robust and great idea. And then we look that is this belt's outer area also okay. And then when we rotate that belt, we can see that this inside areas must be looked that no any fractures in there, no any parts missing. Look, this is like check to drive belt inner area. And if there is any parts missing, then we have to replace this belt. And this belt is also good to replace within every 50,000 kilometers or 30,000 miles, because this is a critical component. I recommend. And then I recommend to use these Toyota's originals belt, because they are the best. Please visit in Toyota Dealership Center. Okay, here is the system. Looks good. And then there is a trick that if we try to rotate that in that way, and if we could to easily rotate in that in half way, like in that way, or actually it is, we need to use force, then it is, this belt is in right fasten, this tightness is okay. If we use force, and then we can rotate that belt. And there is then this locking bolt, what we need to open if we like to change this belt. And then look also my another videos where I showed that how to open that tensioner and how to replace this belt. I have a couple of another belts also. And in that area in here, there is air condition system. This air cooler's location. It is same idea in that area, just down in water pump. Okay, thank you.